Today, we are going to look at a BodyViz Brain Builder about the integumentary system and melanoma. Melanoma, the most dangerous form of skin cancer, affects the largest organ in the human body, the integument. In this Brain Builder, we will discuss the anatomy of the integument. The integument has many functions, including protection, synthesis and storage of lipids, excretion of wastes, regulation of body temperature, synthesis of vitamin D3, coordination of immune responses, and finally, sensing environmental stimuli. The skin has two main layers, the superficial epidermis and the underlying dermis. The epidermis is a multi-layered structure comprised of keratinized stratified squamous epithelium. There are two skin types, thick and thin. Thick skin can be found on the palms of the hands and soles of the feet and have five specific layers. Stratum basale is the deepest epidermal layer and is where most of the cell division happens. As new cells form, they move upwards, replacing cells that wear off from the skin's surface. Pigment-producing melanocytes are scattered throughout this layer and inject pigment into neighboring cells. Cells from the stratum basale move up to the next layer, the stratum spinosum. Mitosis continues in the deepest part of the stratum spinosum, adding to its thickness. Two crucial cells in this layer are melanocytes and Langerhans cells, which aid in the skin's immune defense against cancers and harmful invaders. Above the stratum spinosum, the stratum granulosum is the last layer that contains cells with a visible and functioning nucleus. These cells produce proteins called keratin and keratohyalin to protect against microorganism threats. Stratum granulosum cells also release lipid-rich granules through exocytosis to make the skin water-resistant. Exclusively in thick skin, the stratum lucidum cell layer has no functioning organelles or nucleus within their cells. They are packed closely, bound by fully formed keratin proteins. The outermost layer, consisting of dead, keratin-rich cells with durable cell membranes, is called the stratum corneum. This layer is also found only in thick skin. Intercellular connections from the stratum spinosum remain, holding cells together. This layer acts as a protective barrier. The dermis is located deep to the epidermis and is composed of two layers, which ensure the skin remains intact, nourished, and responsive to the environment. The reticular layer is the deepest dermal layer, packed with connective tissue fibers, which envelop various structures like blood vessels, nerves, hair follicles, and glands. The papillary layer, composed of loose connective tissue, anchors the epidermis and houses capillaries and neuronal axons. Next, we will look at the formation, treatment, and prevention for melanoma and then give a patient example. Let's discuss the formation of melanoma. Melanoma is the most lethal form of skin cancer. Melanoma tumors occur when healthy melanocytes in a normal mole transform into malignant cells. A melanoma tumor may appear on any part of the skin. Left untreated, the tumor will grow deeper into the skin towards the dermis, where it has the ability to metastasize. There are four types of melanomas that differ in their growth patterns. Superficial spreading melanoma appears flat and is usually 2 centimeters in diameter, with the edges and color varying in appearance. Nodular melanoma are melanoma tumors that are typically blue-black, though some, while rare, lack pigmentation. Lentigo malignum melanoma start as small, freckle-like lesions but do not stay this size for long. They enlarge to 3 centimeters or more, becoming tan, flat lesions with notched borders. Acral lentiginous melanomas occur more commonly in people of color. These lesions can occur in the palms of hands or on the soles of the feet and are flat and look like stains with irregular borders. 5-year survival rates of melanoma depend on the timing of the diagnosis, with stage 0 melanoma at 97% and stage 4 of melanoma at 10% or less. The most common form of treatment is surgical removal of the lesion and the tissue that surrounds it. Lymph nodes associated with the surrounding tissue are also removed. Skin grafts are used to close a patient's wound. Additionally, chemotherapy is utilized to prevent the spread of malignant melanocytes through the lymphatic system. There are many things that can help avoid melanoma and detect it in early stages, such as a regular skin examination for an unusually shaped or rapidly growing mole, avoiding long-term sun exposure, using a broad-spectrum sunscreen, wearing protective clothing, and seeing a dermatologist. Finally, let's take a look at a patient example. You receive your patient's file and take a look. Age, 58, sex, male. Chief complaints, an unusually shaped mole with multiple colors. You invite the patient into your office for an examination. Your patient states that they have noticed a mole is growing rapidly and looks pretty abnormal. You decide to perform a skin examination and biopsy as you suspect this patient may have melanoma. You confirm that he has a mole with pigment spreading from the border to the surrounding skin. The skin biopsy reveals a positive melanoma result. You inform your patient that they are lucky and have caught the cancer at stage 1. Accordingly, you and your patient discuss a treatment plan based on the extent of the cancer. Your patient undergoes surgery to remove the mole and the surrounding skin. The removed sample will be viewed under a microscope to ensure no cancer cells were left behind on the edges of the skin. For now, this is the extent of the treatment, but regular trips to a dermatologist and self-care regimens are highly recommended. This is a classic example of melanoma. Thank you for watching this Brain Builder video. Please like and subscribe to our BodyViz channel, or if you are new at BodyViz, check out our other anatomy resources and schedule a demo at bodyviz.com.